What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 12 of the Ultimate Let's Play Bass Masters Classic. And today, we're going to finish up the Sydney Lake Tournament. Now, I've had kind of a roller coaster ride in this tournament. I caught the big monster fish on day one, had a kind of a disappointing day two. So hopefully I can end day three on a high note. First thing I want to do is make sure my lures are maxed out here, that I'm as equipped as possible. I mean, if I could rack up maybe 35 pounds of fish today, I'll consider it a success. I think right now I am at, I believe, 89 pounds flat on this tournament. Alright, so I've done all I can here at the bait shop. So let's go ahead and hit the lake. It's going to be another cold day here at Sydney Lake. It's not Lake Sydney, it's Sydney Lake. I'm going to start my day near the docks. Now, a lot of the big ones weren't biting yesterday. I don't know why. So, hopefully we'll have a reversal of fortune today. I'll probably just stick with the spoon bait. Right away, it looks like we got a taker here. So, off to a flying start here. Though this guy's going to really make me work to bring him in. He's 80 feet out. And it's still only 7 in the morning. I'm still waking up. Really, if this was real life, I'd still be asleep. It's the reason why I work in the afternoons and nights as opposed to in the mornings. Well, then I don't have to deal with traffic while driving to work. But yeah, if you're going to be an angler, you got to learn to get up early and be able to bear the cold. Okay, so our first catch of the day has made it to the boat. We're going to put it right in the live well. Looks like a pretty good sized boy here. Clocks in at 5'6". Okay, a modest start for the day. I still got a 40-pound lead over second place, right now being held by Crispin. Really, because I've caught that monster, I think the odds of me losing this tournament are slim to none. Right now, it's just going to be just trying to go for a high score here, as if I was at an arcade. Which, speaking of which, I'm going to the ZapCon convention in Mesa. At the time I'm recording this, it's about, I think, 2 or 3 weeks out. Although it's probably going to be this episode's probably going to be posted after I come back from the convention. See, I like to record my videos way in advance, just so I have a backlog so I can keep my schedule. And we got ourselves another good-sized catch here. Our second one of the day. Let's see if it tops the 5'6" one we caught. Hearing some popping noise there. My line was strung out to its maximum tension there, so don't want that to snap on me. Yeah, I think I am using the 40-pound line, so it should be sufficient enough to handle any fish I may catch here. 5 pounds, 4 ounces. So another 5-pounder. 10-10 on the day. Now we're at 99 pounds, 10 ounces. And we're not even an hour into day three of this tournament. Wonder if I can crack the century mark before 8 o'clock hour. I do want to be careful of where I pilot my boat here, though. I don't want to get hung up on this rocky terrain. And I definitely had my fair share of dealing with rocks both previous days of this tournament. There were times where I thought I was going to get stuck and couldn't get free, which would have been just disastrous had I not been able to get back to the docks with time. and would have gotten DQ'd for the day. Okay, we got another one coming here. This will put me over the century mark for the day, even though it looks like a small one. I don't want that pike, though. I want that pike to get out of the way. Got another pike now in the way. I thought the pike grabbed the line there. I'm a little bit of difficulty getting this bass to bite. Here we go. Well, I am going to go over the 100-pound mark here, but it's going to be after 8 a.m. before I can reel it in, so fell a little short of my first goal of the day. But nevertheless, this will put me in triple digits. All right, we caught him. Let's go ahead and weigh him. Clocks in at a flat 2 pounds, so it barely meets the minimum requirements. I still got a 40-pound lead, roughly a 40-pound lead in this tournament. I'm in the really deep water here. Rid of this pike here. Oop. Got a possible taker here. Oh, got another bigger one here. Who's gonna bite first? Oh, we got three. Wow. I want one of the, whoever's the biggest one of you, please take my bait here. I'd be really pissed if none of them take it. Alright, I think I got the biggest one of the bunch. Now let's see if I can reel him in. Okay, managed to bring him in. Let's add this guy to the live well. Now there's a good catch. 7 pounds, 5 ounces. My top catch of the day so far puts me at 108 pounds, 15 ounces. Where were all these fish yesterday is what I want to know. Caught the previous episode, I actually caught less than 30 pounds of fish, which I think was my lowest score of any day of the tournament so far, and unfortunately this pike grabbed my bait before I was really ready to start hunting for bass here, so I'm not going to be able to keep this one as it's not a bass, but I don't want to lose a spoon bait this early in the day, so rather than cut my line, I'm just going to go ahead and reel it in and throw it back. So, yep, I have just caught something other than a bass. Caught a 15-pound, 8-ounce pike, which unfortunately would be a good catch if it was a pike tournament, but unfortunately it's not. So, therefore, it's as good to me as nothing. So, try a different part of the lake here, moving a bit further south. Sworn there'd be some fish around here. At least that was what my fish finder was telling me. nothing. That was a little disappointing. First time I had to reel in a line and not catch a fish there. There are a lot of beeps around this area. Don't get too close to the rocks here. Right in this corner. Let's see if it's anything worthwhile. This is shallower waters. Yeah, unfortunately, there's no more monster fish to catch anymore. I'm just gonna be looking for the bigger bass now. Not the pike. What we got here in the background? Is it coming toward me at all? Yes, okay, it's coming towards me. This looks like a bass. Perfect spot for it. And it's a big one. I'm glad he stuck around. Well, that was just rude. He was coming for a meal, and the guy just swipes it out from under him. But luckily, this seems to be another big one, so I can forgive that, although that fish is probably really pissed that he's missing his meal. He had his food literally swiped from him. Makes me wonder what goes through the fish's brain when he's trying to reel it in, if anything. Yeah, I'm not going to be killing these fish or eating these fish. I will be releasing them back into the water. 5 pounds, 5 ounces. Alright, moving on. I've got a full live well, so now just gunning for the big ones. Let's see what more I can add on to my total. See another one coming. Let's bring it down to the seabed here. This looks like a small one, but as long as it's bigger than 2 pounds, I'll be able to keep it. Probably only add a couple ounces to my score. Is all this effort worth it? All right. A lot of work, very little payoff. A payoff of one measly ounce. I'll probably be throwing this one back as soon as I catch another bigger one. Now on the eastern side of the lake here. There, right to the east is that hidden lake, which is not on the map. Try our luck here. Okay. I'll let this sink all the way to the bottom. Mm-hmm. are the fish here? Alright, finally. Come down a little more. This looks like another small one, though. I swear, though, some of these days have been going by very quickly. This day seems to be kind of dragging on. And to tell you the truth, I don't think this guy's going to be enough to make the live well. Let's see what he's going to bring to the table here. Only 1 pound 15 ounces. That does not qualify, even with an empty live well. We're past the 10 o'clock hour. This day is kind of dragging on for me. I think it's because I caught all my fish early on. Now I'm just looking for, just trying to max out my score here. That pike getting away from that one. Alright, let's get this big one. And a mighty big one at that. I want to say this is probably a 7-pounder. Hopefully it's a 7-pounder. Wasn't breaching here, really made me struggle with that one, though. He's not really putting much of a fight there. 5 pounds, 6 ounces. I thought it was going to be a little bit bigger than that. But now I'm at 117 pounds, 10 ounces on the day. Let's see if I can break the 120 mark. That'll be my next goal. Still not even at the halfway point of the day. That is deciding. I decided to spend the full time on the full 8 hours on the lake, which I'm probably not going to plan on doing. I mean, if I build up a comfortable enough score, I'll go ahead and dock early and go to the weigh-in. Let's see if we can add this guy to the live well. This guy's breaching here, so he's wearing himself out quickly. Put up a fight, but in the end, I won out. So, let's go ahead and weigh you. 2 pounds, 1 ounce, too small for the live well. Wow. My small fish is 5'4", so I shouldn't even be going for those small ones anymore. I didn't realize that my smallest fish was that 5'4 that I caught. I think it was, my second catch of the day? My first one was 5'6". I think that's how it worked out. Alright, let's see if we can catch a couple of big ones here. A couple more big ones. As we're approaching the 11 o'clock hour. Mm-hmm. Oop, there's a big one. Alright, this guy is gonna be a challenge to bring in. He's putting up a fight here. If I can get him to breach, that'd be good. That means he's wearing out and I'm need a little rest. If I can get him to wear himself out, he'll be that much easier to bring in. All right, we just hit the halfway point of the day. I'm bringing in another big one, weighing in at a whopping 7 pounds, 6 ounces, putting me at over 30 pounds for the day. And I'm 4 ounces shy of 120 pounds for the whole tournament. So this is turning out to be quite a run here. I'm just gonna ride the momentum as far as I can here. 120 pounds is definitely in striking distance. I'm thinking maybe going for 125 afterwards, if I've got the time. I mean, it's not even noon yet, so still got plenty of time left to fish. This guy came in from the rear. I don't think it's gonna be worthwhile though. This guy looked kinda small. Yeah. Oh, this is the one I want. If I can reach him, if I can get him to turn around, this is the one I want. Whoa, and that pike almost intercepted it. Okay, now I've got some distance between me and the pike, and the bass makes the grab. Not a lot of line to reel in, so this guy should be a relatively easy catch. Well, this guy's giving me a fight here. Won't go down without a fight. But I got him. Another 7 pounds, 6 ounces. I'm now at 32.13 on the day, and I'm at 121 pounds, 13 ounces. So I have cleared my 120 pound goal. Now what the hell, let's go for 125. I'm probably gonna stick near the docks though, since this very well may be a short day. If I meet my goal, I may just consider just docking early and going to the weigh-in. Enjoy a nice meal before the actual weigh-in. Alright, let's bring this guy in. Well, this guy looks kind of small, so he's probably not going to make the live well. Yeah, I know I could just as easily cut my line, but again, I don't want to waste a lure, especially a spoonbait. So we're just going to catch him, weigh him, and throw him back. So what's this guy weigh? 1 pound 15 ounces, it's a sucker, so I'm just going to throw it right back. So I got to catch, it has to be at least 5 pounds 6 ounces to make the live well at this point, so I can really only put bigger ones in. try a short cast here. I knew I saw something overhead. It was a pike. I haven't seen any trout today, which is kind of odd. But yeah, pikes have been coming up aplenty. And I don't want them anywhere near me. Yeah, I already tried to snake one of my spoon baits. Big 15-pound pike. Which unfortunately would not count towards my total. I think that's so far the only non-bass that I've caught throughout this whole LP, as a matter of fact. This guy doesn't seem to want to bite. I think these guys may be too small. I might as well reel this guy in. This guy's not going to be the live well, though. All right, we're past 12 o'clock now as well. So I'm starting to run a little low on time. Wow, and Crispin and Casey have really caught up. They're almost at 80 pounds each. Makes me wonder if this the last tournament in this LP, they're going to actually make me work for that kind of a lead there. So the last tournament very well may not be a shoe-in after these first few tournaments in the LP. So you know, I may actually have to really have a lot of good days fishing when I reach the final lake, which will actually be after Sydney Lake is complete. After this tournament's over, we'll be heading to the final tournament of the LP. Hopefully those guys will actually make it a bit of a challenge. I'm hoping. Really, these first few tournaments have just been... Well, I'm going to beat these guys relatively easily. Whoa, big one right there. Like I was saying, it was... where was I? I was beating these guys and winning these tournaments very easily by huge margins. And now, competition is actually starting to get a little bit more fierce. And by the time we reach this final tournament, which is one I will have to win, I cannot finish top three or top five, but yeah, hopefully they'll make me work for it. Hopefully it won't be a sure thing. Sound like games like that, they're too easy. We catch a 7-pound 4-ouncer. That's going in the live well. One of the 5-6s is going away. One more 7-pounder will actually put me at my 125-pound goal. Just trying this little crevice here. Hopefully, we'll actually put it on the rocks. No, I won't. Okay. Taking a bit of a risk throwing a line right where I did, because I could have easily gotten stuck on the rocks and would have lost the lure. I see something in the distance here. Can't tell if that's a bass or that was a trout. I caught just enough of the outline to help me determine that that was a trout, and that's actually the first trout I've seen all day. Don't want that was another trout there. Don't want that one. I'm running out of line here. Thank you. Did not find anything there. So I'm gonna change positions real quick here. Oop, I'm actually touching the dock right now. See if I can catch anything here. Just like one more big catch in the day, and I don't want that trout. There you are. You're the one I wanted. About to hit 1 o'clock, so we're definitely running out of time for this tournament. But maybe this fish is the one I need to help me break 125 pounds. Okay, let's weigh this sucker here. Not a sucker, it's a lunker. It's 7 pounds 5 ounces. Wow, 36.10 on the day. That's gonna put me at, I did it, 125 pounds 10 ounces. So I reached my goal for the day. I'll definitely be winning this tournament. You know what? I got time. Maybe I'll do just one more cast for fun. Maybe one or two more casts, depending on maybe if. Maybe I'll get lucky. Maybe even top this. I'm really just going for personal best right now. I mean, I know I'm going to win the tournament. But let's see how much more I can get. I doubt I'm going to break 130 because I've already got 36 pounds in the live well. Definitely one of my better days of fishing. If you do not count the first day of Sydney Lake where I caught the monster fish. You know what? Maybe I'll be adding on to my total after all here. Let's reel this guy in. Bit more to go here. I've only got about 20 odd feet here. Okay, well, let's see if we're going to be adding anything to the live well. It's 6 pounds 5 ounces, but it's not big enough for the live well, so unfortunately I gotta throw this guy back. Well, I'll be honest with you, at this point I think I've done all I can do. Call it a day a little bit early. It's not even 1:30 yet, but I'm going to go ahead and weigh in. Let's see what the final results of this tournament are. Clyde Casey crept into second place with 83.1. Corey Crispin at 81.9. They will be the two and the three as they show off their catches today. And now for the trophy presentation and the payoffs. That's four tournaments now that I've won. Going to go for the sweep in the next tournament. Wow, what a payday. $10,000 for winning the tournament, plus another $10,000 for catching the monster fish. So I'll walk away 20 grand richer from this tournament. So that was definitely worthwhile, which probably means I'm going to be able to upgrade my boat for this final tournament coming up. All right, so final tournament of the LP, Lake Calabasas. It's warm and it's murky, so this is the grand day of all bass fishing tournaments, so I've got to win this one. And hopefully these competitors will make it a challenge. We'll see in the next episode, but I'm going to call it quits for now. So I'll see you next time when we will start the tournament at Lake Calabasas. Until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.